Hello everyone, thanks for coming to Data My View. In this video, I'm going to explain how to create procedures inside SAP HANA. You know there is a major change in SAP HANA Studio. SAP has deprecated the procedure option from SAP HANA modeler perspective. Let me show that. If you are new to SAP HANA, if you want to create a procedure using SQL statements, you can connect to your SAP HANA system and you can go to content, and if you have filtered anything, you can remove that filter so that you can see all the packages. Let me go to any one of the packages, and if I try to click new, and I can see an option called procedure. So procedure is another way where we can easily build a model as like a calculation view or analytical view, but with the help of SQL statements. If I click procedure, you can see an error message: creating procedure is duplicated in the model perspective and is not supported. Use developer perspective to create procedures. So basically, it is a development oriented thing, so they have duplicated from this SAP HANA side or SAP HANA model perspective, and they have added this feature in SAP HANA development perspective. So we were using SAP HANA model perspective to create these procedures, and once we created these procedures, that procedures will be added under catalog. So under our schema, we have a procedures folder, which I will show you now. So here you can see, this is my schema. So under my schema, I have different folders, which is different objects used in SAP HANA. So here we have a procedures folder. So under procedures folder, we have a few procedure folders, sorry, procedures. So previously we have to create these procedures from SAP modeler perspective, and once we validated and activated, those procedures will be created under this procedures folder. So since we want the error message, we have to go to SAP HANA developer perspective. So as you can see, I am in SAP HANA modeler perspective, it has been selected. If this particular section is not visible, you can go to window and you can go to perspective and you can choose which perspective you want to go. So alright, so I have this tab, so I can click SAP HANA development perspective. So it is going to change the look and feel about the left hand side. So left hand side add systems, so it has connected to SAP HANA system. If I click this SAP HANA development, it is not just to create a stored procedure. So with this HANA development, we can create applications using JavaScript and many more things. So alright, so if you want to create a procedure inside this, so you can create a folder and you can assign, you can create a procedures under the folder. So I'm not going to create any folder. So here I have a project, so which I connected with my SDB HANA system. So if I right click this, I can go to new, and I can see different options like new project, new database table, file, folder, and access related information. So here I couldn't find any procedures. So to see that, I need to go to others, and here we have different objects that we can create with the help of SAP HANA development perspective. So one of the option is stored procedure. So this is one we were trying to create in SAP HANA model perspective. So they have more this. So under model, we have analytic privilege, analytic view, attribute view, and calculation view. And procedure as we move to output. So okay, click this stored procedure and click next. Here we have to choose on which folder we want to create, and here we need to name the procedure. So let me name this as demo underscore store procedure, and we have to set the target schema where we are going to create this demo underscore st store procedures. So browse is going to list out all the schemas that we have in SAP HANA system. So I'm going to choose best schema where I'm going to develop and activate this particular stored procedure. Click finish. So once you have clicked that, it is going to create a basic template for you where you can easily feed in your SQL statements to create a procedure. Alright, so this is the syntax. So to create a procedure, we have to type procedure and the schema name, and this is my project, and this is my stored procedure name, and the language is SQL script, since we are going to write everything on SQL script. And SQL script routine vocal, these are the default things, we know and told you about that. And here default schema, we already defined the schema here, so no need to worry about that. You can remove this. So basically it's a comment where if you add two lines before any sentence, it will make that as a comment, and you can see that in a green color line. So if you are familiar with DSQL or SQL Server statements, then it is very easy to create these procedures. Even with the help of SQL statements, you can create a calculation view which is based on SQL script. If you are not familiar with SQL script, please without me, I can help you to learn SQL scripts. So it will take at least one day to learn about SQL statements. Here I am going to create a simple procedure to show only tab name, field name from this DD03L. So DD03L is the data dictionary table which has all the tables, fields inside the HANA database. So if you have a bunch of tables and all the dictionary elements data will be stored in this DD03L. So here I am trying to see only two columns from this table, and again this is my schema where I have created this table and populated the data. So once this is done, make sure you are creating this colon and enter. So that's it. You need to validate this, so right click here and validate. Alright, so once you validate it, you can see new procedure has been created. Alright, so here you can see a diamond icon which is denoting that it is not activated yet. Alright, so to activate that, you can right click this procedure, you can go to team and you can activate, or you can right click on the same window where you type the SQL statements, you can go to team and you can click activate. So it is going to validate all your syntax and try to see any issues or any mistakes. So we have already change log, so I can choose that and click finish. So this is going to be activated. Right. So here you can see activation got success. So if it is failure, then it will show in a red color. So it is saying that completed successfully. So here you can see that diamond icon has gone. So we have activated that. To access or to call this stored procedure in our SAP HANA models or views, we need to go back to the HANA model perspective. So I'm just going back to the HANA model perspective to test that whether we have this procedure created and it is ready to use. We can go to same schema where we stored the procedure. Let me refresh this folder. So this refresh, here you can see a demo underscore sp, the one we created. So to call this stored procedure, we need to go back to the SQL console. So it's a place where we have to write SQL statements. So if you have created a views or models, if you want to test whether it has produce the current data. You can go to SQL console, you can type that view name in the select statement and that will display the results. So as we created a procedure, we have to call this procedure. So I'm going to write the syntax call and that's it. Call then procedure name. Then execute this. So it is going to give you the results. It is very simple to create a store procedures in SAP HANA. And if you want to learn more about SAP HANA, SAP modeler, sorry, HANA modeler and business objects. Also, if you have any doubts on SQL statements, you can write your comments below this video and I'll try to help you out. And also I'll try to help you to learn more about SAP HANA and business objects and SQL statements. So if you like this video, please subscribe. And if you want to learn more about that, you can ping me in the comment section where I will try to reply for your comments.